Hi everybody, Catherine from Moraware here. I am a member of the marketing team, if I haven't met you already yet at an event. I am always looking to learn more, even if it's in our own company. And so one of the things I was really interested in is kind of getting to fabricators a behind the scenes or behind the screen, if you will, because we're a software company. Yeah. And just figuring out if there's more that you guys want to learn. And so we thought we'd start with product. We have this awesome new product manager, Chelsea, and I thought I'd sit down and ask her some questions about what happens when you make a feature request. And am I right in guessing that, you know, giving it to support is the best way to do that? What happens when we start developing a new feature and how much work goes into that? And what's the process until it gets into your hands? And how do we let you guys know that? And how do we keep software running? These are my main questions that I wanted to know. So I thought it might be worthwhile to just video the call that I have with Chelsea asking about it and letting you all see behind the screen and what those answers are. So I hope you like it. Thanks for staying tuned. And as always, give me any feedback of what you'd like to see next or see more of, or if you even want to see it at all. Well, let's start with an introduction. And so just tell us who you are, what you do at Moraware.
Yeah. My name is Chelsea Hendrickson, and I'm a product manager, which essentially means I work directly with Moraware's development team to improve and release new ideas and features into our software that'll help our customers with efficiency and their overall business.
That was a great description. That was really well put. So I guess with that in mind, most of the fabricators that I talk to at different events and stuff, you know, they have a million feature requests every time, you know, every time we go to a shop, people have a million great ideas of what they want to see. And we know every shop is unique. So what happens when somebody requests a new feature or they want something to be a little bit different? How do we manage that on the product side?
Yeah. So the feature requests come into an internal system in Moraware, and weekly I go in and I pull all of those feature requests out and I categorize them, and then I organize them and compare them to previous feature requests so that I can see what the top requests are. And I look at it as an overall, what's the top request? I look at them at the system level as well, systemized versus CounterGo. And then I also look at the category level. Are we talking about jobs? Are we talking about quotes? And we compare the top 10 of those. And that's sort of where all of our next things we're going to work on come from, are those feature requests.
Right.
So that's what very important.
Yeah. I always try to be like, the more you put in, the more it's going to move up the list, right? Because I'm sure, and you know much more than I do about this, but there are feature requests that we hear more consistently, right? Like there are ones where, you know, they're higher up on the list because there's so many requests for that. Is that true?
Yes and no. So essentially each request that comes in, I'm looking at overall like votes, like how many people have requested something. But I'm also looking at what is the problem that they're trying to solve? How complicated or difficult is that problem to solve? And does that request align with Moraware's goals ultimately as well? There's also smaller requests that come in that may not get a lot of votes, but maybe they're really easy to implement. Something simple for us to do that we know will improve our customers' overall day-to-day, and it's a quick, easy win. And we'll grab those as well.
Right. I never really thought about that. So would that be kind of like the feature, one of the updates we came out with last year, I remember was in CounterGo, reducing it from 3 inches to 1 inch on the backsplash. And that seemed really small, but it made a big difference for a lot of our customers because they're like, finally, is that an example of one that's easier to do?
Yes, exactly. Something that won't take a lot of development time, doesn't require much, if any, design work. An easy thing to implement that we know will save people a lot of time.
Awesome. And we've been coming out with more of those, not to brag too much, but I know since we've added to the team in the last year or two, we've been able to kind of push out those smaller ones. And I know we're working on bigger ones now, which is exciting. I wish we could share those, but we have to
not yet.
Do it quietly. So in addition to that, when you do get these requests and you guys, I'm assuming as a team, get together and discuss, you know, with the votes and the workload, you know, how does it, once you decide to do a feature, what happens from there? And again, I'm like a fabricator. I know nothing about development and I don't know how any of this works. So I'm learning just as much. So you guys have decided on a feature X, Y, or Z. And then what do you do after that? What's the process?
So it starts with our designer, Kelly, and I bouncing the problem off of each other to say, hey, you know, what could solve this problem? You know, what are things or multiple things we could do to improve whatever the situation is? And then we take that idea and we go and we interview customers, willing customers that are willing to just jump on a Zoom with us real quick and talk about the problem as they've experienced or how they usually interact with whatever portion of the software we're talking about. And we'll get some feedback from them. And then we'll take that and run with it. And we'll build a prototype with a few ideas. And we'll run that by some internal folks like support and onboarding who have a lot of interaction with customers, get their feedback. We'll iterate on that a little bit. And then we'll build the prototype to take to customers. And so we'll have a few Zoom calls. We try to get as many people as we can to get a wide breadth of customers' feedback. And if we're on the right track, which I'm hoping we are, then we'll take it to our development team and they'll tell us how technically complicated it is to implement. And we may have to pivot a little bit based on, you know, technical constraints, but we will always work to find a solution for that problem. Once it's in development's hands, we'll then work with internal departments to make sure we have documentation and support for when that feature goes live. And sometimes if it's a larger feature, we'll do like a beta where we actually put the feature on a few customers' instances and they can use the feature. They get new access to something brand new that nobody's seen yet. But at the same time, it's so valuable for me because I get to get all their feedback and hear, are we on the right track? Is this working? Is it not? Because we want to make sure everything we do is going to be a benefit to the majority of our customers.
Right. And so if, say, because I talk to fabricators quite a bit and I know, and I try really hard not to, you know, spill the beans or get them too excited. But if somebody wanted to be part of beta testing for features in the future, is there a list we keep or do you reach out very specifically according to the whatever the feature is that's coming out?
So I'm trying to build a list. If you want to be on the list, email product@moraware.com. I want you on my list.
Special shout out.
Yeah. Generally, what I'll do is go through the feature requests and see who has requested or complained about something that is related. And then I'll contact them first to see if they want to talk about it and have the time. Okay. I'll also sometimes just reach out to people who have actively engaged before. And sometimes I will cold call it. I'll pull a list of customers and just reach out and see if somebody wants to talk.
So what you're saying is, in this case, complaining or being more vocal about what you would like to see is actually really helpful because it provides you with a list of people to get the prototypes out to.
Yes. And I'm trying to build a list of people who want to be contacted, like I said. So
yeah,
the more the merrier.
More aware. That is awesome. Well, we'll definitely put that in the, you know, like, hey, people, please do that. And as marketing, that's really helpful because sometimes we don't know how it works and we don't know if that's okay to do, right? Like I never know whether if I'm talking to a fabricator, it's okay to tell them to reach out or if that's going to hinder you in any way. So it's really good to know.
Yeah, definitely not a hindrance, only a benefit.
Another thing I think is really interesting and that I don't know enough about, but there's a lot that goes on behind the scenes with software and keeping it just running smoothly. And I've heard quite a few times at different in-person events, people being like, hey, we've been using your software for 20 years, never had a problem, never had a glitch. It's never been down more than like, you know, an hour in the worst case possible. Like it always keeps everything running smoothly. What goes into that? I have no idea. I'm always like, yeah, we've got a great dev team, but is that a lot of work? Is it easy? Is it just servers that we take care of somewhere else? Teach us all.
Yeah, it's a combination of things, but mostly it can be attributed to our amazing support, onboarding, and development teams. We have a group of people who truly care about our customers' experience, and that makes all the difference in the world. The support and onboarding teams let us know the second they hear that something might be out of place or wrong. And they, you know, work really well at communicating back with the customers on what the status is, what's going on, and what they can expect. They also are constantly sharing with us any feature requests or pain points they've been hearing about. And they are always working to make sure that they understand any new features going out and that they're up to date so that they can fully support it. And then our development teams are always working to not only implement new features, but make sure our infrastructure is set up in a way that can support everybody. And they're always working on bug fixes. Sometimes they're working directly with our support teams to understand what an issue is and make sure they get a fix out. And sometimes they can come up with workarounds or alternatives to keep the customer working and keep their workflow going so they're not put out or put aside by whatever fix is going to take however long. So it's a constant, to them, credit to their hard work and how much they care about our customers and how their day-to-day goes.
We've got a very awesome support team. They are the best. And I ask them a million questions a day, so I should probably get one of them on these calls too.
For sure.
They know everything.
And a developer too.
But yeah, I'm constantly pinging Annie like, what does this mean? What? So another plug here is, please, fabricators, sign up for our emails, our newsletters. That's where we list new features. We will sometimes, if it's big enough, it goes up in the software. Am I right, Chelsea? It pops up sometimes.
We're working on a more streamlined, we're working on a more streamlined way of handling that. But we are trying to do more notifications in the software itself, like, hey, this is new, check this out.
Right. And on the marketing side, we always put it in the newsletters, we email about it. We are trying to get better at that too, but you have to sign up to get those, and we would love to let you know more. You've been with us, what, almost a year now?
No, 6 months.
6 months, that's it? No way.
Yeah.
Oh my God, you've done amazing work in 6 months, and we're so glad
you're here. Thank
you. You've had so many conversations with fabricators in the last 6 months, more than probably most of us did in our first 6 months. But what have you learned about this industry? I mean, I know you came from a different industry, just like most of us, and you kind of have to jump right into something you never really expected to know a lot about. Like, the amount of stuff I know about countertop fabrication is kind of crazy now. I can't look at countertops anymore without knowing all about how they were created. So what are some of the things you've learned from fabricators in your conversations over the last few months?
Everything. I knew nothing about countertop fabrication at all. I came in from a luxury travel market. It's very different. But everybody has been so kind and open and willing to share. And I am still learning. I have so much still to learn about just the entire fabrication process in and of itself. But I've learned that Moraware's customers are warm and kind and engaging, and they're willing to tell me exactly how they feel and exactly what they want. And I want to hear all of it.
Yeah, it's really helpful. Would always take transparency.
Yeah. And I mean, I never even knew what kind of countertops I had before I started.
Just pretty one.
No, I need new ones now.
I know. Well, now luckily, you know, a few fabricators to see if they can get you a little discount. Well, I think this has been awesome. Is there anything else you want to add to this? Or I can also afterwards do like a pitch and say, hey, please send in your feature requests or whatever you need help with. So
yeah, absolutely. I want all the feature requests. I want them all. And I, you know, if anybody's interested in providing feedback, we have more feedback opportunities coming up. And I absolutely would love more people that want to engage. So that I'm not just spamming people, demanding help.
Right. That's awesome. And that's really good to know, because I will definitely add to your list as well when I talk to people.
Great.
Thank you so much. I just kind of wanted to have this short conversation about what goes into feature requests, what happens when somebody does that, because I feel like a lot of times, you know, in person, people have these awesome ideas and I just keep repeating myself and I'm like, send it on to support because they send it on to development. And now we have you, which is a really great kind of in between because you're talking to our customers and development and you're getting the ball rolling. So I will keep pushing that. And I think this has been great. It's really educational for us who don't know what goes into developing products, and it's exciting.